Have you ever seen those mini photos that look like little mini stickies and you can stick them up on a digital website or your social media site? I'm going to show you how to do that in Photoshop.
Sorry if it's hard to catch my vibe. I need a lover to trust. Tell me you're on my side. Are you down?
What's up, guys? TJ here with another video. If you like these types of videos, please like, share, and subscribe. Really appreciate it. Also, hit that bell icon so you can get notifications whenever I release new videos. So today's video is going to be about creating the mini photograph, like the Polaroid photo style pictures. I'm going to show you how to do them on Photoshop with your own pictures. I'm also going to show you how to create a PNG photo that's going to have a transparent background so that you can stick these anywhere, whether you want to put them on a social media site, whether you want to put them on your YouTube page, whether you want to put them on a website. I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. Also, I'm going to stick them up right here on the photo, on the video, so you can see what I'm talking about. You can actually put these on video. So they're really cool when you're creating slideshows and different things like that. And we're going to get into the computer now. All right, we're going to start with going to Google. We're going to type in Polaroid photo PNG, and we're just going to go down here and choose a Polaroid with a transparent background. You notice it's a transparent background because it has this little checker pattern on it. I kind of like this one because it's dusty and crusty, just like the old Polaroids looked. You can also find them sometimes that have like a little piece of tape at the top, and that kind of adds to the effect. And I'm going to kind of attempt that whenever I show you how to put your photograph inside of the Polaroid casing, if you will. All right, so I'm gonna try to put this on my desktop so I can find it easily. Wherever it went, I don't know where it went. All right, so we're gonna go to Adobe Photoshop. Now, I will show you after this how to do it with PicMonkey.com. I will leave a link to PicMonkey.com in the description section below. You can try it out free for 7 days, I believe, and then it may be $6 or $7.99 a month. I'm not exactly sure, but you can check it out. Just if you want to make a quick thing, you can do it for free with the free trial. All right, we're going to create new, and we are going to just do a square, whatever photo, because we are going to open a photo that we already have. Let's see, open, and we will find just any, well, we'll find our Polaroid photo first. It was Kiss something. There it is. All right, so we have this, and you can move this around wherever, because it does have a transparent background, so it's just going to move over the transparent background. Whenever you do save it, this little checkerboard pattern won't be in there. So we're going to open up whatever photo, and I'm just going to grab a picture of myself. Ooh, dramatic. All right, so I'm going to put that there, and we need to get it inside of the Polaroid tab. So the only way that I know to do this is to right click on it and open it as a smart object. So we'll convert to smart object. That's going to make it a smart object, and then we can just drag that onto that tab and drop it in there. Hello, nose hair. All right. So we do, this is a very enormous picture, so we're gonna have to shrink it down quite a bit. I took this picture, I think, with my Canon Rebel T6i. So it's a very large photo. So we'll shrink this down to the confines of the Polaroid. So it probably will make the picture look a little bit weird, because when you have a large photo and you shrink it down this small, all those little pixels have to be compressed in a very small space. So we'll just make it a little bit smaller than the actual opening of the Polaroid, and let's see, there we go, and we'll move it over. So the Polaroid is going to actually cover the edges, and it'll be even. I'll show you that in a minute. So you have your layers. The way that Photoshop works, it works in layers. So right now I have the big photo layered over the transparent Polaroid photo. So what we want to do is we want to swap that. So all you have to do is just click and drag the layers down so that your Polaroid is actually on top of your actual photo. Now you can do this with any photo. This is actually just a really simple way to do this. And if you want to, I always add like some little writing down at the bottom. This Gloss and Bloom font is something I really love. Downloaded it on, I think, thefont.com. And you can just kind of change that. TJ Love Lady. And then you can just kind of move it over. So it kind of looks like handwriting, like you wrote it on there with a marker. So that's really, really cool. Now, all we have to do now is save this. Now, when you save this photo, I would save it as a PNG because what that's going to do is that's going to take your transparent background so you can place this anywhere. But before I do that, I'm going to show you how to put a little faux piece of tape up here. I'm not really going to spend a lot of time showing you how to do that. I'm going to put a rectangle, change it to either gray or white. We'll put it white. So it'll look like just like a little piece of tape holding it on. It doesn't have to be in the center. Just you can tilt it or rotate it, whatever you want to do, just to make it look realistic. But I'm just going to put it on here just to show you kind of what I am talking about. So we're going to export this as a PNG file. Maybe. All right. So we're going to export this with the transparent background. As a PNG file. Now PNG files are very, very large. PNGs of photos are very, very large. So you have to think about that whenever you're loading it onto a website or something. So I use these as creatives for my website. If you go on my website, you'll see these little photos on my website. And that's what I use. So I'm also going to show you, see what it looks like if you want to stick it on something. All right, so this is a thumbnail that I made for one of my videos. And what am I doing? Oh, let me open the photo up. There may be an easier way to do this. This is just how I do it. Open it as a smart object and go down to your picture and drag it. Well, you can't drag it. Can't do that either. I'm gonna have to drag it here. That's what I meant to do in the first place. And place it on there. Now it's going to be large again, so you will have to go to edit and transform and scale. You can scale it down to whatever size you want it to be, and you can move it wherever. You can rotate it. Let's try to rotate it a little bit just to give it like a little more natural, like it's stuck on there kind of feel. And you place it. So that's basically how you do it. There's, you know, it's not really complicated. It's not really a lot to it. That's basically how you do it. So now I'm going to show you the way to do it. If you need a quick fix, you want to get it done and you don't have Photoshop, I'm going to show you an alternative way to do it that will require you to have to do a free trial of PicMonkey. Or if you have PicMonkey, you can do it within PicMonkey. So you'll open PicMonkey up. I'll put a link to it in the description section below. And we are going to we will open up our picture here, or our Polaroid. And then we will open up, well, I should hold, never mind. We're going to open up our picture first because that's going to actually be the better way to do it, to layer it on there. So let's see, we'll go, maybe I can add it as an overlay. Instead, no, I'll just open it new. All right, so now we will insert the Polaroid as an overlay. You'll click on the little butterfly, it says overlay, and then you'll open up your photo, you'll insert it. So as you can see, it does have the transparent background. So you'll have to make it large enough to fit your head in, or whatever it is inside of it, or you can make the photo and the background smaller to fit within the guidelines of that. The only problem with doing it like this is that you will have to crop out the sides of your photo, which is not a big deal. You go over here
to crop, and you just crop that right out. All right, so now we have our photo. Now we don't have the little piece of tape up at the top, but if you did have a, if you did find a PNG of the Polaroid with the tape at the top, it will still be up there at the top as long as you cropped around it. And you can also do PicMonkey with a transparent background if you have to. So you can save this as a PNG or a JPEG. If you have a transparent background with the tape, you will have to save it as a PNG. That's the only way you can retain the background.
So that's really it. It's nothing really too hard to do. It doesn't take that long to do. What you will need is you will need the Photoshop. But if you don't have Photoshop, you can achieve the same thing on PicMonkey.com. I think it costs $7.99 a month for PicMonkey.com. I will put a link to that in the description section below and also in the first comment. So if you want to join PicMonkey, you can do that. So that's going to be it for today, guys. Thanks, guys.